Everyone, here I am, Digvita Shah, an aviation and hospitality expertise with a flair for writing and also a motivation speaker. So here I am today presenting a topic about frustration and depression are at all-time high. How do you motivate your team? Okay, so I guess listening to this topic itself is giving someone goosebumps or maybe a bit of a frustration. Hold on. Don't worry, I'll take you through the slides and I am sure that it will make you feel more relaxed. So where do we start from? See, anxiety and anger in today's time with the current pandemic is creeping at all levels. What is anxiety? Anxiety is actually a form of frustration. Both these things are interlinked. How do you think that a team leader should motivate his team? So a team leader has to first be self-motivated. As you say, a leader sets examples, and as you practice, so you preach. So he or she has to himself be self-motivated, and that's the biggest key. This is a long time phrase that I'd written some time back, wherein I don't know if you are able to see it properly, but I'll read it out for you. And it says, life is all about being human, showing humanity always, but not at the expense of being inhuman to the most important person in life, and that is you. So everything begins from yourself. Unless and until a team leader himself is motivated, he will never be able to motivate his team. And during the current times when everything around is changing at a rapid rate at every second of life, I think it's not just even a team leader. Everyone has an equal role to play in the team. You must have heard this phrase that you have to be a rainbow in someone's cloud. It's about sharing those colors, sharing experiences, and learning and growing through experiences. So at this moment in time, though a team leader and a superior will play an important role, but so are important roles being played by peers and colleagues. So you have to come and collate as a team. So let's understand what are the reasons for anxiety during these times. I understand we're all missing the pre-COVID times, but what exactly are we missing of the pre-COVID times? Yes, the hangouts. Oh yeah, I miss them too. Like going out, meeting friends, the personal interaction. Oh, vacations, the planning for that. The entertainment around of movies, music, concerts, etc. And also about comparatively more topside safety and security. Yes, though working in a private sector earlier also, you had that job safety issues, but they were less prevalent as compared to the COVID times. But let's look at some important things that COVID did bring in life. Was the family bonding? Yes, I feel that all were praying sometimes or later that all professionals were on that verge that, hey, I'd get less time because I travel so much and I need to really be there for my family. I don't get to spend time with family. So isn't that an important part about the COVID times, that we got a chance to be with family and there was a family bonding, even for people who are friends who used to stay as bachelors somewhere else, got an opportunity to stay for long and be with their family. Yes, that's an important thing. There were virtual meets. But again, yes, the virtual meets do have their disadvantages that we're missing on the personal interaction. I guess I'll address this in the later slides. Also being alone at home. Yeah, certain times right now, if you're not being able to go and meet your family for long and because of the lockdown and all, that initial frustration of being alone and being there at home was a little bit of a challenge. Yes, salary cuts, multitasking, and also being the fear of the unknown. Why do I say a fear of the unknown or more so the known? While everywhere, everyone else is just talking about COVID, that someone, the other person is COVID positive or someone just expired in my family. All these negative things around are just adding to the frustration and the anxiety. I think that death was a known thing, that like life and death is unpredictable. Like, as you didn't know when you were born, so so would you not know when would you leave this world. But now it is about every moment and everything, and that's the fear of the unknown. But it is more so a known thing that whoever is born is going to die. But so let's go into the next on the next slide, and you will understand how I go about telling you how you could overcome this. So where are we at this current situation, or how do we overcome it? Yes, there was a comfort zone that we were all in during the pre-COVID time, that yes, I can be at my pace, everything is hale and hearty, and I can move around, I can do whatever I wish to, and all the beauties around, and you're not restricted to just the four walls of the house. But change is the only constant in life, and that's the first phase or the first stage that you go by accepting the change. Yes, you need to accept that this is how it is now, and once you accept it and start living with it, you will start eventually go to the next level of adapting to the change and finding out paths, new ways to adapt to the change. And once you go in adapting to a change, you will explore the new normal in a very new way, right? There is a big difference between being alone as well as being lonely. Being alone will always give you an introspection into your mind, even if you're alone, and will give you new ways to understand yourself. So it's all about the mindset. And sometimes I feel it is just about what we lack is the expectations versus reality. Probably most of us are still stuck, including me, to accept the reality that this is what it is now, and you will have to accept this phase, and we don't know, it's unpredictable till when this will last, and you have to adapt to it so as to find new paths to your destination. So understanding this slide in more detail, I have certain quotes for you which go about, like, how is the pre-COVID time? It said, the soul becomes dyed with the color of your thoughts. So as you think, so does it come in reality. So once in the pre-COVID times, it was also hale and hearty. You felt everything is so colorful and all. And you were in that phase. Now the acceptance phase. Now here you have to accept that I am different, just like every color. So like this phase is different than any other phase probably that you must have seen, right? So once you have that acceptance to yourself, you will go about understanding to the next phase of adapting to it, that your intentions will create your reality. So you've accepted that I am different or this phase is different, and you're adapting to it now. And once you adapt to it, you will explore new ways to it. So you will be in harmony with this change just be in harmony and accept and adapt to it and explore new ways. So there's this life goal that I've written, like I spoke about it, the fear of the unknown, or more so the known. Death is a known thing. When it will come, for whom it will come, nobody knows. So it's like, it goes like, life is a movie where the climax is always unchanged, but everyone's story and duration is unknown, and the situations are also unknown. Yet there are certain individuals who live and play their part and get in each and every role so easily that they create an Oscar-winning performance out of life. And when such a legendary leaves, he lives with a goodwill and is remembered for life. Okay, so the gist of this is what I'm trying to explain is, you already know a climax to something, right? I think most of us are fearing the uncertainty of maybe jobs, or maybe losing a loved one or something on that line, or being just stuck with nothing to do. But I think this talks about you have to adapt with every change. And when you try to adapt to every change and you come out of your own limitations and you accept the reality of life, that this is life, you will try to adapt and enjoy along with it. So right now, when we talk about a lot of planning that, I am planning 5 years down the line on this, it is this moment where it is only living in the moment, living for today, living for this moment. You don't know what your next moment is. So just leave each moment as if it is your last moment, but not being depressed about it, but trying to make a memory out of it, right? So that's how I will put it across. I know it is easy said than done. It is equally challenging for everyone, but I guess everyone will have to learn over a period of time to come out of it, to know that, yes, living in the moment and still planning and having dreams is how the way forward is, right? So let's see how the team leaders can start with it and where are we actually failing at this moment in time. So the first and foremost thing is prioritization. Need versus want analysis. What I guess is till today, we were in such a zone that we have certain needs, but we also run behind a lot of wants. At this time, and probably at this moment, everyone has understood that nothing can be taken for granted, especially life to a larger extent. So it is about what is your prioritization. So a team leader can help teammates or subordinates under him to prioritize their need versus want. And each one can also do that at an individual level. Understanding how is their need and what is their need. The next is gratitude. Obviously, I guess everyone says a thank you when someone does good for them or someone is helpful to them. Yes, just saying a thank you and actually feeling it is a different thing. But have you ever thought about thanking the precious gift of life or thanking the little things that life gives us? So let's start with this. Let's each day as we go into the next day, be thankful about the moment that, oh yes, I could see another day and my near and dear ones are hale and hearty and they are safe. So let's enjoy these little wonders and little things in life and be thankful for them. Once we start doing that, is when we would be on a positive line of it that, yes, I have learned to prioritize my needs. I have been thankful for my little things in life. It is as if earlier you used to set those alarms, right? Like 6 a.m. alarm because I have to go to office at 7 a.m. Today, I guess most of us have become lethargic. Yaar, pata hi nahi, what will happen tomorrow? What is it like? But let's not leave that hope with just the pandemic affecting us, saying that everything is unknown and uncertain, right? So let's just have that hope and go forward with it. Again, it's about scheduling. So as team managers, we schedule our tasks that need to be timed. Similarly, on a personal and professional level, each team member can also schedule his task and time it according to the day, a day prior for the next day. You have to also do a lot of follow-ups. Once you adhere to timelines, you will know that, okay, the importance of timelines and scheduling, you will feel less overwhelmed and you will pass each day on a positive note. So yes, but with these times, you should always leave certain space for uncertainties. And I guess a team leader will also understand with the things going around. Yeah, so a team leader has to empathize. See, everyone is sailing in it together, yet it's different for each one. So we will have to all cooperate as a team, as I had said earlier. And I am sure we can all win and we can all come out of it with flying colors. There is another thing of a challenge acceptance. Generally, what happens is when we our expectations are different and our reality is different, we fail to understand this is a challenging moment and we try to run away from the challenge. But once you run away from a challenge, you might find another step. But there will be challenges and there will be roadblocks. It's not about running or skipping and hopping over those roadblocks, but to accept them and to face them, right? So once you inculcate that each day is different and you accept that, you have that acceptance power and you can bring about a lighthearted mood by finding humor or sharing a light joke and surrounding your place with some colorful things and vibrant artworks, which would also help you generate that positive vibe around you, right? So yeah, and I'm sure that everyone would know about the Maslow's law and the Maslow's theory of needs. like I was talking about in the first one, the needs and the wants. So there are some physiological needs, which is like air, water, food, and all, right? Then there are some safety needs, the personal security, employment, health, and property. And then love and belongingness, friendships, family, sense of connection. So generally we say we have to rise above each of the needs, and finally we have to reach the self-actualization need. Where we are stuck right now in today's time is with the lower three needs. So what I will try to explain here is, let's focus on each need at a time. So when you understand your needs, okay, if probably for me, if money is not an important factor, but I need to have air, water, food, shelter, which is like the basic need. Once you have that, and if you're not so much that interested that, oh, money is not my priority, probably at this moment, being safe and being healthy is my priority. So let's prioritize in that way and then go about it. Love and belongingness. I know that probably you are away from your family, or maybe, yes, you're distant from your friends. In fact, I shifted my location from Mumbai to Pune, and I left an entire friend circle behind. So it is different. But have you ever tried to just embrace yourself in a hug and try to love yourself? Try this, and probably you will be like happy that, okay, fine, at least I am here, or my near and dear ones are here. So just give a hug to yourself, give a hug to your near and dear ones. And probably when you focus on these three needs at this moment in time, you will eventually go to the next two levels. Like I said, sleep is good. Right now, being healthy and being positive is all that is needed. So sleep is good, books are better. Whatever is your hobby, just try to pursue your hobby in a different way whenever in a free time. Read some good books, try to just get as much knowledge on whatever topic that you like and that interests you. Dream big and discover new paths. I would not say that you need to change your destination. If I really want to become a writer, it's okay if I don't change my destination. Okay, I'm not finding probably good work right now. I will find it eventually. I'll have to discover new paths. Maybe I'll have to connect through different modes. I'll have to do some more research. I'll have to go through some more videos, or maybe understand some more stuff about writing. So it's all about finding new paths and discovering new paths. What if, okay, I've lost my, I mean, I understand there are people who've lost their job. In fact, I come from an hospitality and a travel sector, which is also the worst affected. What do you do in these scenarios? Yeah, it is disheartening. But I will say that your hobby or some other new thing that you would learn eventually will give you that push, maybe not as much money initially, if money is an important criteria, but at least a push and at least motivation that, yeah, you can do something. And that will give you that confidence to move ahead. Also, stay hydrated, stay energetic, right? And whatever, as I said, whatever you love, just do it more often. Learn something new, keep doing it, and be consistent at it. There is always an opportunity that you can create. Don't wait to create an opportunity. As it was always instilled in our mind from childhood that, oh, I will wear that dress on that special day. I will do that thing on that special day. Procrastination is the first thing that leads to being overwhelmed, and that leads to being frustrated. Like, I'm myself a person who procrastinates a lot of things. And I've understood this time how much procrastination has made me feel overwhelmed about even little things in life, to lose my confidence level in things which I was even good at. So this is a self-experience that I'm talking about. So let's start with this. Let's not procrastinate. Let's just plan small things for the day and go about doing it so that we don't feel overwhelmed and we don't feel frustrated. Again, the same thing, that the reality versus the expectations mismatch. That is what is happening in current scenario. And that's what is creating the major point of change. So once these two things are addressed in a more tangible way, I think most of us will come out of it in a more better way. Don't wait for an opportunity, create it. The word impossible also says I'm possible. Everyone would have heard this, right? But then what is the difference? Like I said, let's set small goals. work on one thing at a time, overcome it so as we instill confidence, and do it consistently. Whatever you like, whatever you do, do it consistently over a period of time. And I'm sure that you would come out of it. For sure, there will be no frustration around, and you would be like completely fine to accept and to do new things and love this phase in life. See, Nowhere. How did you read it? Even I read it as Nowhere. But there's another way of reading it. Now, here. This is your time. This is your moment to live. And this is your moment to make it. Right? Like the Kabir Doha, right? Kal kare so aaj kar, aaj kare so ab. Kal mein farle hoegi, bahuri karoge kab. It is all about this moment and about going through it in the most, most special and a most awesome way that you can live it. All the limitations that you have are always in your head. And once you clear your clutter of the mind, your imaginations will leave you to new destinations, will lead you to new avenues, which you would have never imagined of. So this is how I've explained with the growth mindset and the fixed mindset. What happens is when you are not resilient, you have a fixed mindset. So you have this limiting power that, oh, I cannot face the challenge. This is very challenging. I'm avoiding my challenges. I am not good at this. All those negative thoughts that, how will I do it? There's a lot of effort required. I don't want to do it. I don't have the abilities. Once you go beyond this mindset to a growth mindset, that this thing is a change and this has given me a new opportunity to explore myself, learn new things. And once you go about doing that, to find inspiration and find inspiration and learn new skills, and also find inspiration through other success, you will be more acceptant, and you will also try to be more you would not fear, and you'll not be fearful about it, but you will also accept it with all your might, and you will always have that desire to build and grow and learn, right? Which is what it is all about today. So now I have to explain the part that how as a team member, as well as a team leader, you can all get through. Right. So how does it start with the team leader? How can a team member handle frustration, and how is the direction for the team leader? So for the team member, you should be completely open about it. You should speak about the limitations and inhibitions in open. Talk about all the fears and confide in someone. And don't ever shut yourself down and try to go in a shell by victimizing yourself. Whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, just talk about it in open. And talk about it in someone whom you confide. Maybe mostly your team leader. Do the things that you love to do, and do it more often. Pursue a new hobby, because learning something new and creative will open your mind in a different way and will color your mind to new avenues. Set small and attainable goals. So just don't think about what's happening around. Just don't think about all the negatives. Just set your goal for this moment, for an hour, for 2 hours, and try to take it one step at a time. Love and accept yourself for what you are and enjoy your company. So even if you are away from your loved ones, or if you're feeling that thing of, oh, I'm an extrovert, I like to hang out and I like to meet so many people and I'm stuck at home and all this thing, just try to accept yourself for what you are. Start loving yourself. I had read this somewhere that happiness is never found in external things or external people. It is always within us. And we need to find our doors to our happiness. So remember that tough times don't last, but tough people will always, right? So even this phase will pass. How is the direction for the team leader? I understand that even team leaders are going through different stuff. There could be people who would come around and would be like, sir or ma'am, whatever, like I'm facing this and I don't know how to handle it. Just empathize with them. Listen to your team members. Try organizing a fun time and help each other cheer up in different ways. As we discuss work, right? Let's do something out of work. Let's not discuss the COVID times also. Let's just discuss something about the past, maybe how you enjoyed the parties or whatever it could be. But just allot some time within 15 days to do that. During conference calls, let's let the video on. Certain times I've seen that because people are not properly dressed or maybe there's no professionalism, people keep the videos off. It's like facing a blank screen. Already you are feeling as if you are lost in your own world with nothing around. And again, you're facing a blank screen. So let the videos on at each time during conference call and let everyone see each other to at least have that connect. Talk about the advantages of the new normal. The team leader can say that. How about not meeting me like a torturous boss every day? And you can still gossip about me, right? Offline by connecting to your other friend. Isn't that cool? Rather than discussing it in office there, might be he can overhear you. But when you do this offline, he's not even part of it and will not even come to know about it. So isn't that the fun part? Communicate and appreciate the small little achievements that your team members are making. As there would be appreciative mails going around or maybe like just a pat on the back. I know this is missing, but affirm and just appreciate for the small little things and the small little achievements that people are making. That can be a great motivation to a lot of them, right? Because sometimes monetary benefits don't do as much as a simple word of appreciation makes around. Again, affirmations, positive thinking, and manifestations are a great practice. So just always affirm that everything is good. I am good. I am healthy. I am strong. Or whatever it is, just think that it is happening in your present. Manifest something. Create that thing in the present. And just be positive about it. As much as you believe in your powers, as much as you believe in your thoughts, as much as you believe in all these things, it will come to you naturally, and your negative thoughts and your frustrations will go by naturally. So I have a question. When you see the screen, what do you see? If you focus on, I am not how I feel, I think you are in that zone where you're still trying to come out of it. But maybe if someone is focused on, I'm fully alive, I'm completely enough, I'm safe from harm, how do you feel? Don't you feel like that positive vibe that's coming in it? Isn't the aura around itself trying to change? Because when you see anything with not or anything negative, you will be like going on a little lower zone. Once you see, oh wow, oh, I am my heart's desire, I am full, I am complete, you feel that, oh wow, everything is so good. The energy level automatically rises. So that's the difference. It's all about where you focus and how you feel. See, always inhale confidence and exhale doubt. Self-doubt is the biggest thing that one should overcome. On there could be people around you that would keep doubting your abilities. You should never doubt your abilities, even if it's a first try that you're making at it, or be it 100 times that you've done it. You still have a lot to learn, and you can still progress, and you can still do a better job at it each time. This is just like a board that I've given, and you can try this around by putting these things around and just having a look at it every day. Like I said, when you be grateful for the little things in life, every day is a gift. That is why it is called the present, right? So let's start by thanking each sunrise that we see, right? I am the master of my fate. I'm the captain of my soul. You can reach to your destination, and there can be different paths. Even if one path closes, there could be a number of other paths that could open for you. And it's all about adapting to it. Be courageous, have faith, go forward. Believe you can, and you would be half there. Once you start believing in yourself, you would be confident about it and you would be able to put your right foot forward and present it in such a way as if it's already yours. It's all about believing in yourself. And also there's another thing. Good things come to those who hustle while they wait. So again, an example, right? I was myself not a believer in this, that how much do you wait every time that I apply for a job? Maybe there are rejections. Maybe I don't even get a chance to give an interview or whatever it is. But eventually, your patience does pay off. And this is a self thing that I've experienced myself. And I would say that, yes, good things do come to those who wait. So just believe that everything right is on its way. It's just a part and it's just a phase and it will pass soon. Vision boards. Oh, this is a great thing. You would have always seen that there would be goals set around in your board meetings and in offices, like the quarterly goals, the monthly goals, the weekly goals, and the team leaders would always be talking about what is the target, how much did you achieve, what was the revenue, etc., etc., etc. Have you ever tried doing a self motivational and a personal vision board? Here are certain ideas that I could give about. Try doing this set around vibrant colors wherever you sit and do. Try setting a vision board. It could be personal, it could be professional. You can add to it and just try watching it each day. But you see that this is my vision. This is my vision. I will achieve it. At whatever, set a target for it and you will always achieve it once you understand the importance of a vision board, because when you see it every day, you work towards it and you thrive to achieve it. So similarly, just set all these vision boards. There are some ideas that I've given it out. So this is one other way that you can. So whichever way suits you, just try to make it more vibrant, more colorful, and whatever could be your personal goals, you can just set them out and just keep watching and keep believing in it that they would be there and you would be there getting those. So, and make your own magic. So all these things lead to only one thing, that once you believe in yourself, everything is possible. So you are the captain of your own ship. You have all the magic within you. It's all about introspection. It's all about understanding the needs. A team leader, a team member, a colleague, everyone can help and help you out and go through all of it. Eventually, everyone will have to do it for yourself, for oneself as well, right? So, yeah, that's how I like to close on this positive note, that I am sure that each and everyone would be sailing through it in a happy and hearty, healthy and happy and a hearty way. And I will always